What's up, everybody? We're gonna be reacting to Meghan Trainor's brand new video, No Excuses. Now, let me just give a quick introduction to how I feel about Meghan Trainor. I fucking love her. I love Tidal, the album. Like, Tidal was one of my favorite albums in 2015. I really don't care what anyone has to say about it. I showed it to everyone when it was coming out. I showed it to all my friends, put it on in the car all the time, and everyone's like, okay, these are bops. Like, everyone was loving it, Credit, like, all the non-singles. I wanted that album to be, like, 7 singles deep. I mean, all this, like, you know I love retro doo-wop type of things, and Meghan makes some great melodies. So, then Thank You came around. Thank You was cute. It was a cute album. Like, some of the songs were nice, like, real, like, they were just some bops. The other half of the album was some dog shit. It really was. I mean, let's not try to lie to ourselves, Meghan. Sounded like you didn't even put, like, you just went to the studio, you wrote down some lyrics, and then you were like, alright, this is the end of the song. I mean, there were no choruses sometimes, there was, like, nothing, no production, like, nothing was going on. It looked like you just sketched it down on a notepad, you made a demo, and then you were like, alright, let's get this album out. So a lot of you guys said, no thank you, to Thank You. But, am I excited for this new album? I am. So let's just see what she's gonna serve. If she's serving some urban mess that she was trying to give with Thank You, I'm gonna be a little pissed, but I think she might have learned her lesson. Okay, well, let's see. Already giving me what I need. Woo! It's giving me retro already. Okay. This is giving me, like, she's trying to be funky. She's not rapping, she's trying to give you that funky rhythm. Oh, I wasn't expecting this. She's looking like, E.T. E.T. meets, like, the 90s. There's, like, a lot going on here. Okay. I'm happy with what she's serving me right now. This is very springtime, very happy, very fun. She's looking skinny, she's looking hot as hell. And this pre-chorus is like heavenly right now, so. She gave us what we needed. Music video is very ghetto, like, you know, ratchet, no budget, etc. But she was never one for visuals. But it does look very, like, it's very fun. Like, very colorful. So it kind of looks good. It's just boring. And she cannot dance, but we've been new that, so that's okay. Nah, that's so catchy too. Okay. And she's giving us melody again. I mean, the last album, she was giving us none of that. That's the best part. Okay. Okay, she was looking a little nervous because she's like, are they gonna love it? Are they gonna give me no more excuses? Like, what's going on? But, overall, music video is cute, whatever. I mean, I could do without it. It was just nothing. It was just her dancing up on Mars or whatever the hell she's doing. But it's colorful, it's cute. And she's looking good, so that's great. Now the song, this is what I wanted from her. I mean, I definitely take it. I like the strings going on throughout it. I love the funky, like, rhythm throughout it. I love the pre-chorus. I love how there's melody and then there's, like, rhythm. There's, like, a lot going on. So I'm loving that. It's short, it's sweet, it's cute. It's what we want from Meghan Trainor. We don't want too much from you. We just want something short, something catchy, and something lighthearted, something fun. And so she went right back to what she needed to do. Was I listening to the lyrics? No, I probably should, just because I feel like she might be saying some bullshit that I won't be happy about. So you know what? Let's just real quick, No Excuses Meghan Trainor lyrics. just to make sure she's not saying some dumb shit. Because sometimes she's just saying some like really cocky mess that I don't want to hear. She's looking at me. Okay, have you looked? Okay, your mama raised you better than that, right? I remember that, but what is she talking about? What you sipping on got you going talking crazy, looking at me sideways, always coming at me. Why you acting like you never met a lady? I don't disrespect you, don't you disrespect me. Oh, I like that lyric a lot. Have you lost your mind? Yeah, girl, what? Okay, I see exactly what's going on with this song. Bitch, what she's serving us lyrically is nothing again. Which was my, like, okay, in the first album and titles, she gave us lyrics that were like a story, like you knew what was going on. She literally would build some of the lyrics like a country song, like verse one, here's part one of the song, verse two, we're continuing down the road of the story. This song, and on the songs on Thank You, it was just like, it didn't even make sense. What are you, like, what, where's the story? What are the excuses that he's saying? The person's coming at you sideways, but why? What are we even talking about? And then you know, like, where's the story of the song? I don't understand. She's never gonna give it to us, but she takes the easy way out, and that's what we're gonna accept from her. So I like it, it's cute. Work on your fucking lyrics, give us a story, make some sense for once, but overall, the sound is what she needed to go back to. Let me know how you guys felt about it, and let me know what else to react to. Subscribe for some more, of course, and thanks for watching.